Today, we're going to meet a cool new spider friend called the Joro Spider. So get ready to learn all about these amazing creatures and bust some myths along the way.
Have you ever heard of the Joro Spider? It's a super cool spider that originally comes from places like Japan, China, Korea, and Taiwan.
Recently, it's been making itself at home in the southeastern United States, and even is moving up the East Coast to places like New Jersey and beyond.
Joro spiders love to live in forests and gardens where they can find lots of insects to eat. They're used to living in places with lots of trees and bushes.
Joro spiders are like little rainbows. The females have bright yellow, blue, and red markings on their bodies. Female Joro spiders can grow up to 3 inches long, which is about the size of a credit card. Males are much smaller and not as brightly colored. Joro spiders are expert web builders. They spin huge webs that can be up to 10 feet wide. Their webs are made of super strong, golden-colored silk that you can sometimes see shining in the sunlight. In fact, their silk is super strong and is actually being studied for use in making new materials.
Joro spiders are like little hunters. They eat bugs like mosquitoes, flies, and other insects.
Joro spiders catch their food by trapping it in their sticky webs. Once the bug is caught, the Joro spider wraps up in silk and has a tasty meal. Now let's clear up some myths about Joro spiders.
Joro spiders are super poisonous.
Actually, not true. Joro spiders are not harmful to humans. Their venom is only strong enough to catch and eat small bugs. So don't worry, that's a myth.
Joro spiders will bite you.
Not true, Cadence. Joro spiders are actually shy and usually avoid people. They only bite if they feel threatened. Ouch, you hurt me.
Joro spiders are everywhere.
Not exactly. While Joro spiders are spreading, they're mostly found in the southeastern United States, but are slowly moving up to the East Coast. What?
Nothing.
You said a myth. I gave a fact. So stop laughing.
Joro spiders can fly.
Really? Wait a second. That's not true. Joro spiders can't fly, but they have a cool trick called ballooning. They release silk threads that catch the wind and carry them through the air like little tiny parachutes. And this helps them find new places to live. Get off me.
Get off me.
It's like a web.
Joro spiders start their lives as tiny eggs. In the spring, they hatch into spiderlings, which are baby spiders, and then they start growing.
By summer, they're building big webs and catching lots of bugs. Most Joro spiders live for about a year, with adults laying eggs in the fall before they die in the winter.
And even though Joro spiders are great hunters, they do have their own enemies. Birds, lizards, and other animals like to snack on them. This helps keep the spider population balanced.
Joro spiders help the environment by eating lots of insects. This can be good for gardens and forests.
However, since they are new to some areas, scientists are keeping an eye on how they'll affect the local ecosystem.
Did you know that Joro spiders are named after a creature from Japanese folklore called Jorogumo, which means binding bride? Well, hey, guess what? Now we all know just a little bit more about the amazing Joro spider. The next time you see a web glittering in the sunlight, you might just be looking at the home of a Joro spider.
Thanks for watching, and don't forget to smash that thumbs up button. It really helps out our channel.
It sure does.
Make sure you subscribe. Bye.